Hey guys, this is Gaijin Hunter. The hammer is one of my favorite weapons in Monster Hunter World. It is strong, it's a blast to play, feels really good, and sports some of the best endgame weapon designs out of all the different weapons in my opinion. As of the date of publishing this video, here are my top 5 favorite hammers. Starting out the list has to be the Puke Puke. This one has a wonderful floral design. There's just something I love about wielding a big flower and knocking out monsters in the face with it. It has good attack, it's got very high poison, which is wonderful because larger the monster, the more susceptible they are to poison and the damage that it brings, and it's got 2 level 2 slots, which is really good for decorations. If you notice, it has pretty good blue sharpness, so there's no need to really pair this with handicraft as it doesn't get white, but just overall a very solid weapon for both solo and online play. Next up is Kushara Daora, the most annoying dragon in the game. but look at the design on the scene. I know it's we don't have Kushala weapons for everyone, which is a real shame, but we do have the hammer. It's got this wonderful snake motif, sort of grabbing the ball of the hammer with its teeth. So very cool. It sports top class attack at 1040. It's got positive affinity, a little sliver of ice as a nice little bonus, and a level 2 slot. Steen also comes packed with some pretty good sharpness for blue, so there's no need to use this with handicraft. So just all around a very versatile and just super cool looking weapon. The next one up is awesome. This is the Valhazak's Pandemonium's Root. I know Steen looks like it has a cutting edge to it, but it is actually a hammer. but they chose this design for giggles, which I absolutely love. It sports top class attack, decent blue sharpness. It's got pretty good dragon, 270 with average Elder Seal and a level 2 slot. All this combined with that unbelievable design definitely puts this as number 3 in my slot. And you can actually pair this thing with handicraft, because if you notice, from sharpness plus 2, or handicraft level 2, you already start getting into white. And if you can go 3 or above, you're going to be even better. Keep in mind, white is 12% more attack power overall than blue sharpness. That's a huge jump you can't ignore. With one exception, and that is the Nergigante's final weapon, the Obliteration's Footfall. I kept reading that as football. This thing has a cool design as well. This is top class attack, even higher than Vault and Kushala. It's got super long, that is 80 units of blue. So that's 80 attacks you're going to do before you're going to run out of sharpness. So you'll never need to sharpen your weapon with this. It's got 0% affinity, so no worries there. A little bit of dragon with high Elder Seal. So of course this thing is going to be wonderful for farming those Elder Dragons at the end of the game, and it does come with a level 1 slot. The fact that you don't need handicraft with it, because it actually does nothing, it's got top of class attack, and it's got that high Elder Seal, puts this thing as number 2 on my list. Before we go to number 1, one quick little fact, because a lot of you are asking, the sharpness chart that I have on the bottom right is actually from the Japanese wiki, which is really good at this kind of stuff. Number 1, hands down, goes to Diablos. Now, if you play a weapon like the hammer or the greatsword, you'll know, but this is a weapon where you do a lot of hit and run tactics. So you're going to go in, you're going to do a powerful hit or 2 or 3, then you're going to pull out and then just repeat and stuff. So the higher the attack, obviously the better. This thing blows even Nergigante out of the water with 1196 attack. Sure, it's only got a little bit of blue, but if you pump that thing up to plus 5 with handicraft, do the math, that is an insane amount of damage in a single hit. Thing is, this thing doesn't have an element either, so you can pair this with the elemental list power up decoration or the armor skill, and this will give it an additional 10% raw attack bonus. That's crazy! It's got minus 25% affinity, but if you're using a weakness exploit set, which a lot of people do for hammer since you're hitting the head, you're going to be getting that affinity boost from hitting it anyway, so you probably won't have to deal with the minus affinity too much. And even if you did, if you work out the numbers, it's got such high attack that it still makes it more powerful than any of the other hammers. And of course, let's not forget that it gets a level 2 slot and a plus 15 defense bonus. Yeah. Okay, those are my top 5, and here is my honorable mention. This one has to go to the workshop. This is the one that you get from doing the arena quest. So if you haven't done arena quest, there are special armor and gear that you can make using the coins that you get. I absolutely love the design on the scene. It's got sort of like the scout fly thingies inside the middle floating around. But this is a paralysis hammer, which is good because as you're pounding a monster with the hammer, if it gets paralyzed, that is free stun damage. So sort of they go straight out of paralysis into a KO. It sports decent attack at 936, 210 paralysis, and it's got a level 3 slot and a 20% defense bonus. So overall, this scene is really good. I had a hard time not putting it in my top 5. But I decided to put it at the end because I thought it was pretty cool. Anyways, if you haven't had the chance to check out my hammer tutorial, I'll put a link for it right here in the middle of the screen right now. Let me know down in the comments below, what are your favorite hammers? Did I miss or did I oversee one? And tell me why. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hit that like button if you did, subscribe if you haven't already, and until next time, happy hunting.